Peace, y'all. It's your brother, Cool.
Slow but late, you know, but I got some things spiraling in my head, so I want to talk about them. First thing I want to address is operating in the United States or in any state republic where you're at. And when I say the United States, I'm not talking about the United States Republic or the organic government that was adopted from the law of the Great Peace. You know what I'm saying? The Iroquois Nation, which was all the five civil life tribes put together, meaning El, Ali, Bay, and Day, all put together. So, in layman terms, Cherokee, Chickasaw, Choctaw, Seminole, and Creek, right? So, and of course, these are not the original names. These are the Europeanized names. But, you know, if you haven't heard, the Pope put a civil order out in 2014. He pretty much laid out, you know, that all agents of the United States minor are pretty much out of time. They're out of luck. You know what I'm saying? So the agenda for that trip, because the Pope is the boss, you know what I'm saying? So the Pope coming in 2014 and riding around and visiting all the various states in a fiat, because these Federal Reserve notes are just what they are, notes. They're not dollars. They're not backed by any precious metals like gold and silver. They are fiat. So this is why the Pope was riding around in a fiat. And the point of the Pope touching down on American soil was to, like I said, send a message to all the officials of and agents doing business as United States minor at the Maghrib al-Aqsa, which would be Morocco, the extreme west, which is what we call today North America. And North America includes the adjoining islands, because the adjoining islands are part of North America. All right? So, literally, it is North, South, and Central America. There is no North, South, Central America in the adjoining islands, because the adjoining islands are part of North America. But not to digress, the Pope came down to pretty much express the fact that Obama was the president of a company, and that has having nothing to do with the organic people of the land, which the Pope recognized in his civil order was the so-called African Americans, right? So even the Pope recognizes who the original people are of the Americas. So this is two things, either two types of ways you live. Either you live serving yourself, right? Serving the God that dwells inside this temple or your temple, or you can serve the Pope, and the Pope can take grasp of your soul. And when I say grasp of your soul, understand what I'm saying. I'm not saying grasp of your soul from like a spooky standpoint. If you understand that everything operates as energy, so when you get up, you take a shower, you throw on clothes, you head out to work, that is one time, two, energy. All right? Your time and your energy. So now when you receive a payment or so-called payment at the end of the week or 2 weeks, if you get paid bi-weekly, those notes or fiat are a physical representation of your energy. So literally they're called what would you call those things, like labor, like your labor bills or labor credit. So that's literally your labor. You know what I'm saying? Your check is a representation of the energy and time you put in and what the company that you're working with or contracting with thinks your time and energy is worth. That's what that check represents at the end of the week. If you truly know who you are you can't put a price on what you are, what your time is, and the value you bring to whatever you're applying yourself to. So, like I said, either you serve yourself or you serve the Pope, because everything outside of being Aboriginal at this point is in violation of the organic constitution. So meaning every state literally is in a state of war against the constitution, which is fine if we're on the right side. Only problem with that is we've been on the same side as the state operating as franchisees. So we've been committing fraud, and this is why we have been in a state of rebellion against the constitution. Because we are the state, the people are the state. So if the people minds change, that state change. Meaning if the people mind combine and they realize who they are and they reclaim possession of their estate, which would then reclaim possession of the state as a manifestation, then we can rename the state as a collective people. That is the power. You know what I'm saying? So all these so-called names and territories are not set in stone. All right? Like, for instance, knowing Washington State belongs to or is a part of the Council 18, Trade Council 18, which is the EU, the European Union. So me understanding that tells me that Washington State is in a state of rebellion against the Constitution. So therefore, all agencies operating in this state right now are not representation of Washington State Republic. They're actually representation of United States Minor. I am a representation, the only representation of the Republic, me and my tribe and other Moors or Hebrew Israelites out here who are nationalized publicly on the record and are operating as such, meaning they're not, their spiritual self in the private, and then in the public, they're still operating under that slave brand. That's not what I'm talking about. But irregardless, you're out there. You know what I'm saying? So, if you don't reclaim yourself and you do business in the name of a family bloodline that doesn't belong to you, there's no inheritance for you to receive. If there's no inheritance for you to receive, you have no protections and you are what is considered in law a stateless person, meaning you don't have no nation that you derive from. You're a test tube baby. You're a clone. All right? You're a corporation. You're a person. Which is why anything in reference to the 14th Amendment, if it's a person, it's reference to the 14th Amendment. Unless it's what you consider a free person's. And a free person's is your foreign, private, aboriginal trust that you create outside the jurisdiction of the United States. Because remember, they're in a state of rebellion against the Constitution. You understand? They've already betrayed the Constitution when they allied with the United Nations, a.k.a. the League of Nations, all right, which is what that entity was known as prior to using the modern name today of United Nations. It was before known as the League of Nations. Look it up. And, you know what I'm saying? Understanding that that's the League of Nations. So the United States already fucked up there. They already violated the Constitution at that point, but people are still sleeping. And so now, learning that, and they've probably been in this contract for a while now, but knowing that Washington State, where I'm domiciling at, is in contract with the EU. The EU is in Europe, it's not in America. So therefore, they have also treated and contracted outside of the states, outside of the state republics of America. Therefore, they have committed war against the Constitution in my eyes. it's open season. And if you are not a true American citizen, which has a nationality, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be tough for you, you know? Because like I said in previous videos, the state ID is not you. It's your public trust because it's still a person. It's in all caps. It's still a person. Whether it has your free national title on there or not, it's still a 14th Amendment person. It's not a living, breathing being. So the only identification that any of us as Aboriginal peoples have here on this continent or on this planet is self-identification. That is the only ID that exists. All right? The state IDs after that are just public trusts or gym cards. It has an expiration date on it, like I said before, has your name in all caps. The principles of the game have not changed. An ends legis is still an ends legis. What I'm talking about is creating your own ends legis to operate from. Because if you created it from scratch, that means everything it produces and all the profits and income that's created from those things created from that trust or estate is yours in full, because you are the beneficiary of said trust and estate. So it's time to be yourself. So like I said, either you're going to serve yourself or you're going to serve Rome. You're going to be a slave to the Pope. You know what I'm saying? The game has been over since 2014 in my mind. And look it up. Look up the Pope Civil Orders 2014. You know what I'm saying? The information is out there. So understand what I'm saying. You're putting your stuff on the record publicly to notify these treacherous agencies of what's taking place. Now, I've constructed things in a way, you know what I'm saying, in terms of how I help and mentor people in terms of operations, that you can operate either way. Either way, you're safe as long as you comprehend who you are and you know what you're doing. But if you know how to contract, then you can contract with the state if you choose and navigate it that best works for you. But there are going to be Moors who choose not to do so. And that's okay, because the end game or the end result, once again, is to go back to our own Aboriginal customs and traditions and living and being able to self-sustain through our own institutions. Because at the end of the day, the people are the state. So if the people are the state, that means the people are the United States of America. And the only way to be the people is to have a nationality. You know what I'm saying? So people in Bolivia are Americans. People in Panama are Americans. People in Jamaica are Americans. People in Venezuela, Colombia, Mexico are Americans. Black and African Americans are Americans. You know what I'm saying? So, gotta be able to make the separation between an ends legis and a natural person, a human being, flesh and blood being. The state ID is not your identification, so don't get that twisted. You gotta be very sharp with that. That state ID is not your identification. It's a gym card that gives you public access to public venues that you may need to get into. So it's all about creating things in a way where there's balance and there's the least amount of resistance. And if there is balance, there will be minimal resistance. If there is no balance, it's going to be chaos. All right? So, like I said, it's up to the person or individual. It's up to the natural person or individual in terms of how they operate. But understand that the states are in a state of rebellion against the Constitution. So while we're building up our private estates, we still got to function in this treacherous public society, even though it's in complete violation. Best thing we can do is still operate according to our own principles and customs, being our proper selves and our proper person, operating through our own estates like we used to in the ancient times. That will separate us from the United States company. Not to mention, being separate, you don't have to worry about them, right? Meaning the agents or agencies of said companies or franchises of the United States being able to, steal your energy, meaning take your wages, your hard-earned wages, tax your hard-earned wages. They can no longer do that. That is something that is no longer accessible to them when you nationalize and you do business as yourself. Because just because they're in a state of rebellion and fraud doesn't mean that you have to participate. I chose to no longer participate, and because I chose to no longer participate, it put me spiritually and physically back in a natural cycle of the laws of nature. So now, being back in the honor of my ancestors, I can naturally be in tune with those things that I once was in my previous life. So it's crazy, because things that were made back then, I can still use today that will affect how I enjoy my life here on this earthland, depending on whether I'm in honor or not, and whether I know enough about self, enough about my own history and legacy and antiquity to know of these things that are in place for us to use as a people. Because every other people of a nation and nationality have things or laws or treaties in place for them so they can operate and maximize and get the best out of whatever they do. This is how they come over here and they're able to open up businesses in our communities, because there are certain stresses they don't have to deal with because they are not classified as human property, point blank and period. All right, they still have constitutional protections and treaties in place due to the fact that they have a nationality. So that automatically gives them the heads up. This is why there can be stores in our neighborhoods that stay closed for years. Nobody in the neighborhood can open it. Strangers from another place come and they open a store. Boom. Again, snap out one, but you know what I'm trying to say. You know, just like that. So we got to come back into being ourselves. And start putting things back into balance. Things are not in balance. So it's not a question of, you know, going back into the system. Because let's not forget, the system is a matrix. Let's not forget that. The system is a matrix. So when we step into the public, you're literally plugging into the matrix. So if we understand that the matrix is... If we understand that the matrix is an illusion, then obviously that isn't somewhere we want to be permanently all the time. It's like being at your job and never clocking out. Why would you want to be at your job all day long? Don't you want to go home? Don't you want to be able to chill and relax? Public and private. So, you know, you plug in, you do what you need to do, and you plug out. All right? But understanding that your private rights, your God-given rights, are constitutionally protected as long as you are in honor. So there's private law, and then there's public law. Just like there's a left brain and a right brain. Left leg, right leg. You understand what I'm saying? A yin and a yang, the public side and the private side, the yin and the yang. If the yin is in more control than the yang, there is no balance. There has to be a balance, meaning there has to be some give from the yin, some take from the yang, and vice versa, some give from the yang, and some take to, and some take from the yin. That's the only way it's balanced. It's called the figure eight, reciprocity. So, once again, you have a natural person. Let me just... I want to make sure this hits home. And this is why it's crucial that for those who don't have a national ID, I'll suggest you get yourself a national ID, because your national ID is your only identification. Alright? Arby Bay Publications is good for that. That's why I got my national ID through. Until I learn how to manufacture my own. Other than them, I can reference you to a good brother. Never met him physically, but I watched some of his videos on YouTube, and he also does card manufacturing. His name is Judahson, J-U-D-A-H-S-O-N. He's on YouTube. Just type that in and look him up and get in touch with him from there. All right, he does custom national IDs for people. So there you go. Two options you can go. So I'm going to break this down. Okay. You have your private, you have your public, and you have your private. This is not an ID. This is not ID. I want to stress, this is not ID. You know why it's not ID? Because the name is in all caps. Oops. The name is in all caps. Therefore, this is an entity. This is the public trust. This is an ens legis. This is not a live flesh being. Not to mention, there's an expiration date. Okay? I don't know when I'm going to expire. I'm just trying to reel it home. This is not ID. This is a gym card for Washington State. This is ID. Self-identification. This is my identification. This is my gym card. This is my identification. Public, private, private, public. Over here, I operate through Zodiac Constitution and Treaty. Over here, I operate through Washington State Constitution. Zodiac Constitution and Treaty. Washington State Constitution. Private, public, Social Security, foreign trust, tax, tax exempt, 14th Amendment, a natural person in full life. Civil little mortus, improper persona. I'm just trying to lower self, higher self, negative, positive. I wear this hat sometimes, I wear that hat sometimes. If we're talking about the Matrix, right? Thomas Anderson, Neo. Okay? Thomas Anderson, Neo. Alright? So, the Matrix is an illusion. It's an ens legis. This is why this is necessary to do business, because all entities are spelled out in all caps because they're ens legises. They are illusions. They don't exist. But this is how we're operating in commerce, because we're not actually using gold and silver. We're using Federal Reserve notes, which aren't backed by anything. So we have to operate fictitiously. Okay? This is not me. This is me. You got to be able to separate the two. Public, private. Public, private. Okay? You plug in when you need to. And when you're done, you plug out. But at least when you plug in, you are always yourself. If I go, say if I take Matrix, for example. When the movie first started, right, the first one, Neo was Neo, right? Meaning that when a movie started, he knew who he was already. He was already awake. He was already aware of the illusion, right? Because people already knew him as Neo. After that night, he woke up that morning, was late for work. In the public now, he's getting his ass chewed up by his boss. Corporate America, quote unquote, right? Representation. And then his name there was Thomas Anderson. So right now you're seeing Neo, his private side, Thomas Anderson, his public side. Okay? Now, when Neo unplugged from the Matrix, and he came out and he stood up that test tube for the first time, and he looked to his left and right and saw rows of people in test tubes. That was a representation of how many people were still asleep. Oh, shit. Right? And then Morpheus breaks down when they get into that white room a couple scenes later into the movie, that the whole point of the system is to turn human beings into batteries. And Morpheus is holding a battery. Pretty much human resources. All right? So meaning that we're operating blindly under other family names, doing all the work while they're reaping all the profits, aka taking our energy, the battery. You understand? We're the battery. We're fueling their endeavors, their wars. Okay? And our children are left nothing. So when Neo woke up and he unplugged and he went back in, he didn't go back in as Thomas Anderson. From that point on, he went back in as Neo. Neo was Neo. He was Neo in the private, and he was Neo in the public. So this is, I'm trying to lay out a blueprint for y'all, so y'all can see the game. This is a game. This public shit is a game. It's not reality, yo. It's not reality. You know what I'm saying? Reality is the private side, but we have to play the game to get out. Right? Have to play the game to get out. So this is the reason why it is crucial to move forward in your free national name publicly. Because understand now, when Neo went back into the Matrix as Neo, there were things that now he could do that Thomas Anderson could never do. Now, let's relate that. There are things as a national, someone who has a nationality, who has national character and honor in honoring their ancestors. There are things they can do that Black and African Americans and Hispanic and Latinos can never do, like own property for one, like not have to deal with the yearly stress of having companies take out finances from what you're making every year. As a national, you don't have to deal with that stress. You don't have to deal with that spell. So there are certain things you can do as yourself that you could never do being someone else. So Neo could never do the things that he would do when he went back into the Matrix than if he went back in as Thomas Anderson. So this is why it's crucial, like I said, to go back into the system as yourself. Meaning, I'm Cool Mari Su-El in the private, and I'm Cool Mari Su-El in the public. But I am still cognitive and aware of the fact that when I'm in the public and I'm operating with this is not me. It is a person. I still hold dear in my heart that this is me. Well, not me, but this is a representation of me. This is the true, authentic representation. This does not This does not speak of who I am or where I come from. This does. So this is right here on my heart chakra. This is on my root chakra. Or I should say my pineal gland. So this would be on my pineal gland. And this would be on my root chakra. Higher self, lower self. Ens legis, natural person. So when you're able to make these differentiations, you'll know exactly what to do, when you need to do it, and when to get the fuck out of Dodge. Meaning unplug out the matrix. You ain't supposed to be in the matrix all the time. The same way you ain't supposed to be at work all the time. You can't work 24 hours every day. There is no job that will make anyone work 24 hours every day. They can't do it. You can't be at work all the time. So why would you want to be plugged in the matrix all the time? Why would you want to be in an illusion all the time? The point of the illusion, like I said, is to grab what you need to grab and get the fuck out. Do what you need to do and get out. Go back to Zion. All right? Machine world, Zion. Machine world, Zion. So, understanding these things, you will know exactly how to operate. For commerce. Because we got to make a living. And I'm the type of person where I'm really enjoying working for myself. I'm really happy not being on someone else's time. Yeah, it's a whole lot more work. You know, like right now, it's, let's see here. It's 3 a.m. in the morning right now. I'm still up. Some of y'all sleep in the... Wake up for work in the morning. That's fine. I'll be up in the morning too for work. Because my work is my life. You see what I'm saying? My work is my life. So, I'm always having fun. I'm not on someone else's time. It's a really, really beautiful feeling. It's a really, really beautiful feeling. And my focus now is to just sustain that and maintain that, because you know it's kind of like once you get a taste of a certain experience, you can't go back to certain shit. That's like me nationalizing and now exercising certain powers that I wasn't aware of that I had. Now you want me to go back to being black, being African American, to being powerless? I can't do it. And if I did do it, I would die slowly. I would die slowly but surely. Because you can't, once you know the truth, you can't live a lie. Only shit left to do is to go insane. And I'm not willing to go insane. I want to live my life happy. So I got to be true to me. And that's my truth. You know, that don't got to be your truth. That's my truth. And I'm living it. And I'm loving it right now. And this is a feeling that everyone should be able to feel. To feel what ownership feels like. To be able to say, nah, that's my shit. And if you touch my shit, it's gonna fucking cost you. You can't put nothing above that feeling, all right? And that is a feeling that our ancestors were very, very accustomed to, a feeling of ownership and a pride in your trade, whatever it was. You know what I'm saying? For me in particular, jewelry and stuff like that, music, you know what I'm saying? Consultation, you know what I'm saying, help with research, different things that I do that these are just things that are innate in us as people. We were naturally tradespeople. We were naturally merchants. Merchants. Naturally, we were merchants. So, we always traded. We always had some dope shit we was creating, and we was putting it back out into the world. You know what I'm saying? And that's how you got to live. The only way to live is you got to feed the planet. Because the universe blessed us with our talents and our gifts. So if we don't use them, it's a disrespect. know what I'm saying, to the creators or the Most High. It's a form of disrespect. But when you do utilize, you know what I'm saying, those different talents, those different aspects of yourself, those different creative sides of yourself, and you feed that back into the earth in the form of, let's say if you're a painter, or you're good at making clothing, or you're good at doing videos, or you're good at, you know, creating, whatever it is, any form of art, cooking, whatever form of art it may be, and you're able to give that back to the people in the form of trading. Now you have something of value you can trade. When you give something back to the earth like that, the earth will take care of you. So now when you have a service to offer the people, they will trade with you. So in change, now you can now barter and trade and help sustain yourself. Now you can live off of your own energy, off of your own things that you create, that come out of you. But for me, I wouldn't be able to do that if I was still operating as a Black African American, because there is no constitutional rights that any court can recognize. They don't recognize colors, and colors can't own anything. So I wouldn't be able to do or be able to even if you are working on someone's schedule, once again, the name of the game is to save up, grab what you can get from the public and make your moves into the private. But think about how much happier and how much quicker and smoother the transition will be if you were able to go out into that public or plug into the matrix and be able to grab what you can grab without no one that you don't know dipping in and taking something out before it gets to you. If you can go in, put your hours in, and get your whole check, get all of your energy back, and then take that with you back home into the private, that would speed up the process. And we all would be a lot more financially well off. We wouldn't be as tight and floating barely above water if we didn't have such encumbrances or curses placed on us due to the fact that we classify as a thing that makes us non-descendable, meaning we don't have no inheritance now, no type of lawful protections that we can enforce. You know what I'm saying? So this is what it means to be Black African American, where you are under a curse. If the sun is out and you're Black and African American, there's a dark cloud just over you, raining, thundering. You got some tornadoes on the way and shit. You know what I'm saying? It's just complete chaos. And that's what it means to be Black in society. And so this is why we can feel like other people have rights and they can experience and enjoy certain things, or they can walk to certain things, when we as so-called Black or African American people got to fly to the shit. Because Black and African American people don't exist. So if they don't exist, there's no way that people that don't exist is going to be placed over people that do exist. It's really that simple. So if you don't honor your ancestors, which you don't have no tie to any type of history on the planet that aided in the development of civilization. This is what this represents. This is a symbol of civilization. This ain't no scary, spooky shit. Who else built pyramids besides us? We built pyramids all over the place. This is our seal. This is the Great Seal. I operate through the Great Seal of the government. This is why there's two seals on that dollar bill. Understand what I'm saying? Let me break it down for y'all. Should have it down. This shit is sick. This is the seal. This is the same one I'm rocking right now. See that? This is the Great Seal. I hope y'all can see that. This is the Great Seal of the United States. But you'll never see politicians speak under this seal. You'll never see politicians speak under this seal, because this is our seal. This is the seal of the Aboriginal peoples. This is the seal of our government. And we've been sleeping. So this part, this side of the government has been idol, because we've been on this side following the idol gods of Europe. And so we've been sitting asleep. You know what I'm saying? Capacitating. And this side of the government has been, right, asleep. Because when we are asleep, this side is asleep. So this is the republic. This is the democracy. This is America. This is the United States company. You understand what it means now to be an American? You got to represent who you are. But you got to know who you are first. You got to fly your flag. Fly your seals. Be in the name and thought process of your ancestors that came before you. Because through this seal, I can exercise powers and rights that I have, that I always had. But these are laws left by my ancestors specifically for me, so I can operate today and get the best out of what I'm trying to do, because I am them, meaning the ancestors. I am just a clone of the ancestors that did before me. So when they did what they did in terms of the trees and the things they did commercially to put things in place so we don't have to deal with certain encumbrances, they were thinking about themselves, because they know that we are them. So I was thinking about myself so I can operate today. I thought about that lifetimes ago. And I manifested it today so I can operate. Meaning I manifested the Treaty of Peace and Friendship. I manifested the Zodiac Constitution. I manifested all the treaties that prior to that. So I can operate today without any encumbrances, without anyone getting in my way. Because I am a direct heir and descendant from the great seal government of this nation, or this continent that we call America, which is really Al-Marak, right? Because this is the Maghrib, Al-Aqsa. You know, it's just trying to get through. Just trying to get the message through. Just wanted to hit home clearly, you know, which side you represent. This is the private side. Which side do you represent? I'm always me. Even in the public, I'm still Neo. I'm still cool, Mari Su El, in the public. And so now, being cool, Mari Su El, in the public, there are things I can do that Reginald Claudel Jules could never do in the Matrix. Y'all see the game. But the same way Neo had to sit there and he was able to just download all those information on how to fight and knowledge and keys on certain things, we don't got nothing like that. So you got to put the time in. That's what that was a representation of. They just cut corners. But irregardless of the fact, he had to intake information in order to be Neo, in order to be prepared to do the things he could do in the Matrix. So in relation to that, study. You have to study. And if you don't know where to start with the Zodiac Constitution. Then go right into the Treaty of Peace and Friendship, 1786. Then after that, go right into the Ordinance of 1787, which is the operations of the treaty. Then after that, go into the George Washington letter to the Sultan of Morocco in December of 1789. You know what I'm saying? Then you can start branching off into the expatriation of the United States, expatriation and citizenship, of the United States. Congressional record number 75. There's so many, like, I'm just giving you the basics, you know, because there's no point in studying all these other laws if you don't know your own law. And if you don't know your own law, you don't know how to operate or function, meaning you don't know how to be yourself, because you don't have no type of proper etiquette when it comes to dealing with foreigners, you know what I'm saying, or trading with foreigners and making sure that your I's are dotted and your T's are crossed. So and then you come home with everything that you put out. But ignorance of the law is no excuse. And dishonoring your ancestors is considered ignorance of the law, which puts you in a state of no excuse. So that being said, just, you know, think about what I said, and we'll build and keep moving forward. All right, fam. Peace.